Hello and welcome. If you have not reached this video through one of my modding guides, the link to the guide is in the video description. Before you can remod your Mass Effect installation, you have to restore from your master backup whenever you have installed texture mods and want to remod to add or to change DLC mods. To restore your backup, open ModManager and select Backup and Restore in the top menu, then select Restore. Select your Mass Effect installation folder and click on Restore this target. Once the restoration of your master backup is finished, you can move on with remodding your installation. Importing and updating mods is fairly simple. Just drag and drop the downloaded archive onto the Mod Manager window, make sure the right mods are selected in the list on the left side, and click on Import Mods in the lower right corner. Modding Mass Effect 1 is not really difficult anymore. Just make sure to install the LE1 Community Patch first, as many mods rely on it being installed. Just a side note here, as the installation of some of the mods is rather lengthy, I have sped up the video in some places. Some mods, however, install additional textures, which have to be linked into the main content folder, so Mass Effect modder can find them. For this I use the Link Shell extension by Hermann Schienagel. You can find the link in the video description. Go into the mods DLC folder, right click on the textures TFC file and select Set as Link Source. Then go into the main content folder, Cook PC Console, right click anywhere and select Insert as Symbolic Link. There's one more detail to keep in mind. Some mods install compatibility patches whenever certain other mods are installed. But while some mods let you choose which compatibility patches to install, other mods do not let you unless the other mod is present. You have to take care of the installation order in this case, for which I use a modding checklist, so I do not have to remember which mods need which other mods. A link to my LE1 modding checklist is in the description of this video. Some mods let you choose mutually exclusive options and provide screenshots for you to decide which way to go. Both options all need the same file to be changed, therefore you can only have one at a time. But most of the options are simple on and off decisions. Once the prerequisites for certain mods are installed, the then needed compatibility patches are automatically selected. Some still have to be activated by hand, because those are affecting options you have chosen when you installed those other mods. These cannot be detected automatically. After the dependencies of the mods are sorted out, you can simply install the remaining mods in the order of the list. As quite a few mods have exclusive options, I have written my choices into my modding checklist. This way I can remod without having to check all options and having to read all descriptions again and again. Also remember to take notes on the mods which need their texture files to be symlinked. Currently I have only two, so it is not that bad. You can check which DLC mods are installed by clicking on Manage Target. Here you can disable and delete individual mods. The ASI Manager is accessible through the Other tab. Use it to install the PNG Screenshots ASI, which will make your screenshots be saved as PNG instead of Windows bitmap files. The final step is to mod the textures. To do this, open the Tools menu and select Mass Effect Modder for Legendary Edition. Each of the three Mass Effect titles has its own section. Click on Mods Manager under Mass Effect and select the Mods Installer. Here you click on Add to List and select all MEM files you wish to install. I prefix my files with LE1, LE2 and LE3, so mods are grouped by game title and therefore easier to select. Once you have selected all texture mods you want to install, click on Install All Mods. Now do something completely different, because this takes a long time, almost 30 minutes on my laptop. We don't want to wait so long, so I have sped up this video by a large factor. That's it. You have modded Mass Effect 1 Legendary Edition.